think I heard you real good. Can you do it again? Just in case somebody in the back.
To talk to you about a saxophone effect that I enjoy using, where you actually play two notes at one time. I got this idea from watching a Yanni video where it featured a didgeridoo player. And then somehow when I heard this the didgeridoo where he's humming inside his instrument, you know, he's like, I thought about what it might be like to use that sound through a saxophone. I also am a fan of Dewey Redman, and there's an album of Ornette Coleman's called New York Is Now, where Dewey actually sings through the saxophone. So in that clip, Dewey's actually playing more than one note. He's playing a note, then he's also singing in order to create an actual musical effect, if you will. So I actually put both of those techniques together in order to create two notes at one time. And it's definitely an effect to be explored, but from what I noticed, it works better if the lower notes on the horn, and it also works good if you play a low note and then if you sing a fifth above, or if you sing a tenth above, which is like a minor third but an octave above it. So allow me to demonstrate. Here's us singing a fifth. So here's what it sounds like if you sing a tenth. Technique that I use a lot of times if I'm playing a piece unaccompanied, then I can use the chordal approach to kind of create a certain accompaniment under myself. If you play the fifth, you can kind of like create a outline of what the chordal progression is. You can also use the tenth, and it's up to your own discretion in order to make this work out. So the way you put these chords together, I guess when you're first starting out, is to play the low note, play like say play a low E on the tenor, and then you sing the fifth. So I'm actually singing. So when it comes to using this technique, I think you're pretty much only limited by your imagination.
Mm-hmm.
much wraps up my video. Something very brief and kind of like food for thought. You can play, as long as you play a low note, as far as I know, and if you sing a fifth or if you sing a tenth, then you can create some kind of chordal accompaniment. If you find this video interesting or if you think this video sucks, please feel free to leave a comment. Also, please feel free to subscribe and share and check out some of my other videos.